Hello everyone, welcome to my class. Myself Janisha from St. Joseph Composite PU College, Vijaypur, Department of Commerce, Economics subject. In the first episode of this chapter, we have discussed about the concept of development, right? So in that, we came to know about what is economic development, and what is the role of economic development for the welfare of country, and also the definitions, different definitions also we studied, and along with some of the indicators of those definitions like process, real national income, and also for long period. So these concepts we have discussed in the previous episode. So today in this episode I'm going to deal with another one concept, that is underdevelopment. Then let we start about this concept. Then students, what did you understand about underdevelopment? The word underdevelopment denotes a backward and stagnant situation. Why the situation like backward and stagnant? Why it is this position? Because due to the high population, due to the overpopulation, there is a lot of problems will be increases. As a result, the per capita income of the people low and also productivity low. So as a result, the situation of the country will not develop. So the underdevelopment, it is denoted that backward or stagnant position or situation where the people of that country, they are living in the low level because of lower level of per capita income and also lower productivity level and due to the high population growth. Then what is this per capita income? Per capita income is per head income of the population. Per head income, that means individual's income. If individual's income is more than his standard of living, that is also good. Okay, but if it is the per capita income or individual's income is low, then his purchasing power cannot be fulfilled. So that if the per capita income is low, then definitely national income will also low. As a result, the country will not be developed. So this situation is what? Under development. Okay, so we can say that underdevelopment is a situation where country's per capita income, national income, and also the productivity level low due to because of high growth rate of a population. Okay, so then we can say that the country like underdevelopment, there we can see that higher level of a population. Then what is underdevelopment according to United Nations? According to United Nations, means America, an underdeveloped country is one whose real per capita income is lower than that of the USA, Canada, Australia, and Western Europe. That means according to United Nations, so according to them, underdeveloped countries means what? So underdeveloped country is one whose real per capita income level is low. Okay, so those countries, so which countries real per capita income level is low, so that country is considered as a underdeveloped countries. Okay, because the countries like USA, Canada, Australia, and some of the Western Europe places or countries, so their real national income is good. So that national income of country also good. So we can say that developed countries. Okay. So those countries real national income as well as per capita income is low. Then that country we can say that are recognized as underdeveloped country. However, since the underdeveloped nations are capable of development and are making serious efforts to overcome their problems of low income and poverty, and they are now it is called as developing country. So in this way we can say that however those underdeveloped countries, they are trying to overcome the problems like low level of income and poverty, and hence now it is called as a developing countries. Then what is underdevelopment according to United Nations? According to United Nations, means America, an underdeveloped country is one whose real per capita income is lower than that of the USA, Canada, Australia and Western Europe. That means according to United Nations, so according to them, underdeveloped countries means what? So underdeveloped country is one whose real per capita income level is low. Okay, so those countries, so which countries real per capita income level is low, so that country is considered as a underdeveloped countries. Okay, because the countries like USA, Canada, Australia and some of the Western Europe places or countries, so their real national income is good, so that national income of country also good, so we can say that developed countries. Okay, so those countries real national income as well as per capita income is low, then that country we can say that or recognized as underdeveloped country. However, since the underdeveloped nations are capable of development and are making serious efforts to overcome their problems of low income and poverty, and they are now it is called as developing country. So in this way we can say that however those underdeveloped countries, they are trying to overcome the problems like low level of income and poverty, and hence now it is called as a developing countries. The World Bank, in its World Development Report, it classifies the country as high, medium and also low income countries. Okay, the World Bank, so which consider according to the World Development Report, it classifies countries into three ways. One is high, second one is medium and third one is a low income country. So high income countries, medium income countries and also low income countries. And all countries with middle and low income are referred to developing countries. So according to World Development Report, so they has been recognized. So those countries have middle income as well as low level of income. So though that country is called as a developing countries. So India is a prominent developing country that has recorded significant rise in the income since 1990s. So that India is also one of the developing country. Now let us see about indicators of development. Then how to measure the development, economic development. So that is called as indicators. So then economists have advocated different indicators, and the prominent one is based on the income generated in a country and also rest using indicators other than income. So mainly what we concentrate about the income. So income generated in a country, that is what the main measurement of what economic development. So then let me see about, so first indicator, that is income indicator. So income used here a national income. So here income means what? Income of the country means what? That is national income. So then what is national income? As we know that already, the total volume of goods and services which produced by a country during a particular period of time, that is in a year, right? So then how to say that the national income is an main indicator of economic development? Because if the country's national income is high, then definitely economic welfare can be possible. So then how to say that national income can be generated? So national income, that is nothing but income of all the people residing in a country. See, I said already per capita income and national income. So what is per capita income? Per head income of the population. Per head income, per individual's income. So then how it is? What about this national income? So that this per capita income or per head income this totally recognized as what? National income. So the total of per capita income, that means national income is what? It is the income of all the people who are living in a or residing in a country. So then how to say about national income is generated? That is with the help of people's income. So that, as described earlier, if higher the income, then higher is the development. So however, economic progress of a country will be slower. That is due to the population growth, population expands along with the increase in national income. Thus we can say that income is one of the major indicator, that is national income is one of the major indicator for the economic development. Now let us see about one of the picture of a per capita income of a country. In the year 2016, the per capita income of India, it was 1,21,603, and which is about 15% of world's average. So this indicated that 121.6 crores of population. So this national income has been calculated. And also we can say that India is the 7th largest country in the world, that is in terms of national income, but 143, that is in terms of per capita income. So we are in the 7th place, 7th largest country, that is in the world, in terms of national income, and regarding per capita income, 143. Thus, in this way, we can say that if country's national income is good, then economic welfare also possible, economic development can also possible. So that if individuals' per capita income is higher, then national income is also high. Then if national income is high, then economic development can also possible. So that is the reason we can say that income is one of the indicator or the measurement of a national income. Okay, students. So in this episode also, some of the questions will be there, MCQ type questions. So you need to solve those MCQ questions and also practice those question and answers for the examination purpose. Then let us see about those questions. First question will be, the per capita income of India was dash in 2016. There are four options are there, you need to take. And question number two, dash is the 7th largest country in the world in terms of national income. Question number 3, expand HDI. Question number 4, dash is being used as an indicator of development instead of national income. And question number 5, the word dash denotes a backward and stagnant situation. So this is what the MCQ questions. Everyone, kindly please attempt to those questions. Thank you. Remaining part we'll discuss in the next episode. Thank you.